We've got the candidates' closing statements so they can have the final word before voters cast their ballots.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for this opportunity. I know that voters have a big choice to do in November. In my case, I have spent my whole life working for working families, for communities, for women's rights, for immigrant rights. And that's what I'm planning to do when I get to Tallahassee. I invite you to vote for me. You can also have more information in Maria Revelles for Florida and vote for me on November 5 or before, because already the ballots are ready to drop. We are community organizers. We have spent more than, we have had already more than 30,000 conversations in the doors, and we are ready to bring the voices of all of those that are not listening, nuestras familias, to Tallahassee on November. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much for the opportunity. I look forward to continuing to serve our district. I've been in Osceola County since 1970 full time. I have been a newspaper publisher starting out in sales and marketing. I moved up to the publishing world, and then I moved on to nonprofit as it relates to an organization I started, the Main Street Program in St. Cloud, that I started while I was at the newspaper. So I've been very engaged in our community, and with the longevity in the county, I think I have a really good feel for bringing old and new together, because we need to unite our very diverse community. And so I have been very proud to be able to bring that forward. And I do look forward to looking at the mobile home bill some further on, because that is affordable living. Just like we keep throwing money at affordable living, it is affordable living, and these people have had a bad path and they need additional help. And I look forward to looking more at services for our veterans and autism.
This has been our exclusive WESH 2 News debate. You can see it right now on WESH.com, our social media pages, and on air.